I keep my friends close, enemies on a leash. Like me and my haters is literally Siamese. I can define me, but if I let my friends do it, they tell you I'm some bipolar hard drug user. The J gets smaller, I'm loving my zone. No surrounded by an entourage, I feel like I'm alone. A long way from normal, I try to keep it cordial. I made some new friends, meet recording and touring. Shout out to my nigga, it's now for a nigga. Though some niggas back home ain't proud of a nigga. They don't see my vision, grown man mission. They all see my life from a childish position. I'm the mouth for the district, nobody work harder. My heart is in the monument. So
what up YouTube, this your boy Down Low back for another reply. But before then, let's talk about something that's going on in the music industry, man. So a lot of people have a whole bunch of ruffled feathers about what Trinidad James have been saying on a track that he came out with called Liars, in which he's pretty much dissing people and shit. And my first gut instinct when I heard of this is, it's a Trinidad James diss track. Do you guys really catch feelings on that type of shit? But then I started listening to what he was saying. Then it all kind of just came together and like it makes sense now why so many people from New York are so pissed. It's because the truth fucking hurts. Pretty much what Trinidad James is saying is how the South runs New York. And you know what? There's truth to that shit, because every new artist that comes out, they have a Southern flair to them, man. I mean, look at A$AP Rocky. Sound like he could be from Houston. Look at French Montana. Sound like he could be from Atlanta. And you know, I never liked Trinidad James' music, man, but he showed me something here. I respect his mind. But anyway, on to today's reply. Today's replies are that Tito Lopez, Bussin'. And you know what? I like the track because it's different. This is not like any other Tito Lopez track that I've heard. See, but here's the thing that typical people don't understand. There's a difference between liking a song and forcing yourself to like a song because it's your favorite rapper. See, I will not stand here idly and tell you that this song is fucking dope, because it's not. I mean, it's cool, but it's not on the quality that I expect from Tito Lopez. Too many people will force themselves into liking a song just because it's by an artist that they really, really like, instead of just telling the truth that you expect better from this one individual person, in which I know Tito Lopez have done it before, and he's going to do it again. And talking of Tito Lopez, there's been a confirmation not long ago that he's working on an album with John Connor, in which those are two of my favorite artists. That album could be the best album ever. Type shit, if they do it right. But we can only see in due time if they do that shit right. But I will be expecting that shit. But go ahead and peep out this song, man. It's definitely different from a lot of things, man, but it's not on the level that I would say downloaded or anything. But anyway, on to today's article from downloadpass.com. And today's article is about following trends, and point blank, never do that shit. Like, many people think if they following this trend that this popular rapper did, then they can see the benefits that this popular rapper is fucking getting. It's not how it happens. All you're doing by following trends is making another rapper bigger than what you are. Pretty much you are promoting that rapper for fucking free. Because everybody knows where you got that trend from, man. As much as you lie and try to say that you stand on your own or whatever, the truth is in the fucking music, or the image that you straight up fucking jacked. When you follow the trend, man, you're pretty much in competition with everybody else who's following that same trend, and you end up getting nowhere. But if you end up setting the fucking trend, then everybody who's following what you're doing is giving you all the power. Therefore, gonna push you to the fucking stratosphere. That's why you always, always set the trend, never follow it.